Over the past years, Dr. Jeff Wiggins led a research effort that developed athletic helmets using innovative cushioning technology for sporting goods company Rawlings, which has manufactured the helmet for numerous pro and college athletes. That pneumatic technology soon caught the attention of U.S. Army researchers.
These researchers became aware of Southern Miss pneumatic cushioning technology. And as a result of that awareness, we've developed a relationship to evaluate that technology within military specifications for military purposes. This program is actually going to allow us to fully understand whether there are benefits for warfighter protection or not.
The U.S. Army has provided researchers with specific requirements. A number of polymer materials have been tested in labs like this one to see how they would respond to a variety of conditions.
In a sea of very good choices, we're looking for an optimum. So we're trying to really understand what are the key things that we need to measure, what are the key experiments that we need to run to be able to finalize a material that we feel is going to be the better performing system compared to any other system.
All of this work handled by the School of Polymers has led to the development of a helmet prototype using these tested cushioning materials. This Advanced Combat Helmet, or ACH, is undergoing testing inside this facility a few minutes away at the university's accelerator, led by the Southern Miss School of Kinesiology, using environmental chambers to recreate conditions warfighters might face in battle.
Over 50% of the hospitalizations were really due to blunt force trauma. And so the Army really needed to go back and kind of look at how do these ACH helmets protect against that blunt force trauma.
From the University of Southern Mississippi, I'm Layla Essery.